Okay, so we have one match left. It's the men's gold medal final. Recurve. A bit of a battle here. You've got the Paul Brady, a veteran. The veteran. Yes, he's been around a long time.
I don't think he's too young to be a veteran.
Highly experienced Brady Ellison. Against the new guy on the block.
Yeah, I mean, he certainly broke out last year at the World Outdoor Cup, the Hyundai World Cup in Shanghai, where he tore up the draw and got to the final and then won. It shocked the Koreans somewhat. So, new kid on the block, very talented. Held an arrow amazingly long yesterday in his shoot-off, and it ended up being a 10. I mean, it's astounding how long he can hold. I wouldn't advocate that at home.
They're just so strong, those boys from the Netherlands. But he's taken some names here on the way to the final. The guy doesn't do it. Just listen to this. So he beats Nîmes champion, Olympic silver medalist, and World local. Cup medalist, Jean-Charles Valadon in the first round. 6-4, yeah. Then he takes out Chef Vandenberg, his teammate and highly experienced number one, fourth in the Olympic Games, 6-4. Not content with that, I'm now going to take out Ojinek, 2012 Olympic champion, 6-4.
Consistent.
He's been slaying all the way to the final, and Brady's just been shooting 10, so this could be. Hopefully we get some good stuff here now.
We started his indoor season a bit late, but certainly started it with fire.
Yeah.
Coming to the Nîmes final here, he's qualified for the US team for the World Indoor in Yankton.
Yeah.
And of course he'll be expected and will want to go to Vegas.
Yeah.
To do both the Vegas shoot and the Indoor World Cup final.
So Brady's shooting first.
Nine. A little high there.
Yeah.
Bit of a surprise there to the audience.
High nine again. Interesting.
So Steve's gone high as well.
Yeah.
I really do like how Brady's fingers stay on that string. They do not move at all.
That's just something that happens. It's not really teachable.
10.
Much better. Brady. Great shot. So Ellison on aluminiums. Is he the first recurve we've seen one today? I think so.
In the seniors, yes.
Yeah. Yep. It's the oldest argument in archery. Oh, I need maybe better indoors.
Well, I mean, I think if your shot's good, it's going to go in the 10, whether it's a wide diameter or a narrow diameter. Obviously, carbons travel very, very fast.
Yeah.
That's what they're built for, to be light and to fly through the air at long distances and be quite accurate.
Yeah.
I haven't seen actually a compound shooter shoot their X10s indoors yet. I would be interested to see what they come out with.
I just don't think they've got the
guts. I'm sure they've done that at home in practice, so they all know secretly what they get, but.
It's.
really, yeah, veteran is probably too strong a word because he's still quite young, but he's shot for a very long time.
Yes.
First Olympics.
He's been to three Olympics.
Yeah, Beijing was the first one. Those with experience, Butch Johnson, legendary. And it's just amazing how he still comes every year, how he still's motivated.
Yeah, so 10 years on the circuit now, Brady minimum.
Ooh,
that was wild.
Yeah, there's a lot of tension in his shot.
Yeah,
he does
looks
look
back at Chef there. Nice. So Brady in control of this set.
That's better from Steve.
Yeah.
Brady should take on this opportunity to take this set. It does.
Brady's in the groove now.
Just to punish Steve Weiler a bit for that eight. You can't do that in finals and certainly not against an archer of the caliber of his opponent. Still, all is not lost. That's the third set.
Yeah. No, second. End of second. So.
It's because they tied it
3-1.
First. Beg your pardon.
3-1 to Ellison. Now.
I don't think they really, there's a lot for their coaches to say here. It's just to, they're so experienced. They know what they need to do and how to correct anything.
So, Notti's fun fact of the day is so far every recurve match has gone 5 sets.
It's good, that's a good sign. Giving the spectators their money's worth.
Yeah, so every match we've had a couple, 2 shoot-offs so far today, haven't we, as well, so both been excellent.
That's better.
We don't want to see any more of those reds.
Nine.
Yeah, it didn't look good.
Yeah, the slightest bit of tension is going to cause any arrows, particularly something like an aluminium arrow that's very heavy. It does punish you.
Yes. So.
I mean, they're great things to shoot indoors.
Nine again.
But when you shoot them well, they reward you. But
yep.
If you're a bit tentative. There's a chance here for Steve.
There we go. 10-10-10. Much better from Steve. He's a real fighter in matches.
Fist pump
isn't he?
With his teammate, Chef.
Yeah.
Back in the game.
Yeah, Brady with a 10.
That should give him some confidence for the next set.
Yep. So, 3 points each. We're guaranteed 5 sets.
Again, perfect.
I don't know, there is, being out there as a coach, there are, you've got to know your athlete. Some like to be distracted, they don't want to think about, the last thing they want to talk about is their archery. some like to just be reminded of the process of the shot. Sometimes you just need to remind them that the match ain't over. You know, you can be, you know, 4-0 down and next thing you know we're 4-all. In the compound matches it is a bit tougher if there's a big gap, but you'd still want to, people can make mistakes, things can go wrong. A big tennis man yourself, Chris, you've seen it when it's two sets up, match point, next thing you know it's a 5-set
and you've lost,
4-hour marathon. Yeah,
it's a funny thing, sport. It can be very rewarding, but it can really be heart-wrenching at times.
Yeah, you just think why. Brady back in the middle, right, dead punch, center punch.
Hold, but it pays off.
Strong, isn't he?
Match 10 for 10.
I first saw him at the Junior Europeans in 2016, and he won that easily.
I mean, both of these athletes would have suffered heartache as well as absolute achievement, so it makes you stronger. It's glorious now to see these guys hitting the centre. This is what the crowd want.
Yeah.
Just watching Brady's elbow dropping there.
There we go, 3-10 to Brady.
To do the execution.
Ooh, yeah, that's good. It's good, it's good. It's there. I've already written down 30-30 on my notepad. Let's hope I'm right.
Well, let's see. Well, we're quite a distance away, so let's see what the judge comes out with. He's right there. Some work for him to do.
But, you know, just talking about 10 years, Brady. How many times has he won the World Cup final? Four? Mm-hmm. And that seems to be his event. Every year he turns up, he's in the medals.
And he did well last year in Rome. He got to the...
He was second.
He got to the finals. Yeah. Unfortunately, the finals did not go to plan.
No, they didn't.
But that is how it goes. He shot his arrows and, it didn't work that day.
Yeah, but he shot amazing to get to the final.
He did. Yeah, his semi-final was brilliant.
Absolutely outstanding. But Wu Jin in the final was just on another level. But, Lozani was second. Mm-hmm. What did he win, Lozani? He was up there again.
What is that?
Denmark. Oh. I was right. 30-all.
So it's 4-all.
Yeah. So in Denmark, Chef should have beaten him, shouldn't he? But it didn't happen.
Yeah, it was very, very tight. I mean, these guys know each other quite well.
Yeah.
For sure, there's the head-to-head count on the website, but it's...
So
it still doesn't mean anything. That's past. It's what happens in the present.
We just shot 10 tens and 2 8s. And Brady's shot 8 tens so far, but 4 9s. So they've shot exactly the same number of points. Same on set points. Set
a different combination.
Set number 5. Let's see what we can do. Brady leading off. Needs a 10. There we go. 9-star. Does look a bit high. Nice 10.
Brady is obviously the current world record holder at this. Yeah. A magic 5.99.
Great shot. Was that Marrakesh?
He did do that in Marrakesh. Yeah. 90.
The end of 16. So Ellison needs to put this in the 10. Doesn't want to make life easy for Steve. That'll do. Great 10 there from Brady.
Now hopefully we'll be treated to another shoot off.
Yeah.
hold from Steve. Away it goes.
Turn, turn, turn. So, Chef gives him a fist pump, looks across. Brady waiting on a judge's decision.
He's taking his hand off the bow, but they're still not sure. Is that in or
out? I'm sure. I'm sure it's out.
He's got the light and the magnifying glass to be sure. And it's awarded to Steve Weiler from the Netherlands. Wins Nîmes 2018.
Oh. Wow. He's had a rise to the top in the last 12 months.
Applauded by Brady.
So, ...13-10-8. And he's, so he beat Valadon, Vandenberg, Ogenek, and Brady to win that title.
That's a good VIP list to have eliminated, isn't it?
A real list of scalps, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bright future for both of them.